Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up on the show, if you're looking for an easier way to build and automate hosted applications and services, whether in your data center via Azure Stack or public cloud, we'll take a look at Azure Resource Manager templates, a new way to automate orchestration of required infrastructure resources to get your applications or services running inside of Azure. We'll look at what templates can do and how they work, where you can find hundreds of templates from the IT community, and ultimately how all of this can end up saving you time. I'm joined in the garage today by Corey Sanders, who basically runs the team for all of Azure Compute. Welcome, Corey.
Rick, it's great to be here.
So we announced support for IaaS inside of Azure Resource Manager templates way back in May. And lots of focus was made about how it makes it easier to develop apps and that sort of stuff. But something we haven't talked an awful lot about broadly is really, what does it do for the IT side of the house? What problems are we trying to solve for in there?
What we're trying to do is really resolve a lot of the barriers and complexities about deploying infrastructure-based solutions. This goes well beyond some of the PowerShell-based solutions that you've seen in the past, where you'll automate a bunch of deployments. With what we built here, we've made it so that with a single click, you can deploy a large template with a plethora of resources. This can be things like storage or compute, networking resources, but it also has services like websites to be able to deploy all these components together very, very easily. But we don't stop just there. We can also take those same templates, and you can deploy them both in the Azure public cloud, but you can also bring them down into private infrastructure in the up-and-coming Azure Stack. And so with that same template, with that same exact experience, you can deploy all the complexity of those infrastructure components in all of those different environments. To get you started quickly, we have a set of pre-configured templates, which I'll show you, actually one today for SharePoint. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to log right in here to the portal experience and click straight into Marketplace. It's the fastest way to get going. And so I'll click in here, and like I promised earlier, I'm actually going to search for SharePoint. Mm-hmm. And so here I've got SharePoint. And because I want this to always stay up and always be available, I'm going to go ahead and click the HA farm. And then from there, I can go and configure everything I need to configure.
Now, what is that template actually going to end up doing?
So to deploy SharePoint, there's a lot of things that need to happen, as you probably know. The first step, of course, is you need to deploy your Active Directory.
Of course.
You need to get your identity set up, and you need to configure that before really anything else can happen. And so what this template will end up doing, it'll configure Active Directory, not just once, but twice. It'll configure the first one, the primary domain controller, and then it will launch the backup to make sure that you have that HA experience. Mm-hmm. Once that's fully configured, then we'll move on to SQL to get your backend data. So we'll have a SQL VM, second SQL VM, and then the witness to make sure that you can set up this always-on cluster. And once that's deployed, then you go to SharePoint. We'll set up the app server and the web server, and you finally have a full farm with all the users and roles configured on them that you may need.
Now, that's really hard to get done with PowerShell, but how hard is it to do inside of a template instead?
It's really just a few clicks and really a quick few steps. Let me walk you through exactly what I'm going to do here. So first, as part of basics, I'll pick the SharePoint farm name, and I'll pick the resource group. And that's going to be the grouping for everything that I'm going to deploy here. Now that I've gone through those steps, I'm ready to go hit launch.
Now, before you hit launch, though, can you actually show me what the template looks like you just modified?
I sure can, yeah. I can go straight here and hit download template. And it makes that JSON file right available for me to launch in Notepad. And so from here, you can see that I've actually got the entire configuration set up that I mentioned before. What I'll end up walking through is, like I said, first it launches the Active Directory domain controller. And it'll configure the storage accounts, it configures the NIC,
right,
availability sets, so on, and configures that whole thing and configures that twice and sets that up for you. Now here you can see the depends on section. This is the section that defines the ordering. So Active Directory needs to finish first, and not just finish deploying the VM, but actually configuring DNS so that you have the name for how the servers are all going to connect to each other. And so only when that's finished, you see this depends on, we'll start actually launching the SQL always on cluster. Similarly, once the SharePoint farm VMs start going, those also have a depends on to make sure that only after the SQL always on cluster is done will we then deploy the SharePoint farm VMs. And so it creates as much parallelism as the app can allow. And then I just hit OK, and I can launch the entire template. Now, to show you what this actually looks like, I've spun one up ahead of time, just so you can see.
Okay.
And so I'll jump right into this farm, and you can see, straight from here, I've got all of the components that I talked about. Active Directory deployed, I've got SQL, I've got SharePoint ready to launch. And so I can go in and I can take a look at the VMs, all the aspects that are deployed, make sure they're healthy, et cetera. And so what I can also do is add tags to this. And so what tags allow me to do is they allow me to both track what's running in my machines, mm-hmm. and also allows me to check it in the bill. And so when I put a tag on this SharePoint farm, I'll be able to see in the bill how much this is running, and I can go make sure that I talk to people if they're spending a little bit more than they should, if you know what I mean, Rick.
Okay.
And so I can go right in, I can select the tag and type it in and configure whatever names I want and apply that straight to my virtual machines.
Okay. Now, if I compare that to what I would have to do using PowerShell, this would require me to come up with all the logic and all the PS1s and scripts and everything else to be able to do it. Azure with ARM templates eliminates all that sort of stuff. But where do I get started?
Absolutely. It does eliminate all that. And we've made it so it's very easy to get going.
Mm-hmm.
You can go straight into the Azure.com website and go into resources and go templates underneath that. Here, we've got more than 180 templates for you to be able to go in and learn how the system works. You can click through, you can find things, Elasticsearch cluster with virtual machines, go in, and here you'll see the templates available, but down at the bottom, three simple lines from PowerShell to be able to deploy this template, and away you go.
What about access and security? In a services model, access controls are really important. What can we do with those inside of Resource Manager?
Yeah, absolutely. One of the beautiful parts about being able to configure and deploy all of these as a single template is you can also lock them down all as a single template.
Mm-hmm.
So here I'll go straight into my common networking pool that I've already deployed. And if I go in here and I actually want to maybe allow you to have access to this, which makes me uncomfortable, but I'm going to do it today. And I'll go in users, and I'll add. And here you can see I can select a role. And so there's a bunch of different roles that I can do, read-only, contributor, et cetera. And all of these are defined and for you to be able to use quickly. So network contributor is what I'm going to do. And because you're in my domain, I can find you. And there you are, waiting for me to select you. And so with that, I can add one user, network contributor, to this object, and away I go. And so with that, it should successfully add you, and there you are.
What's the vision for Azure Resource Manager going forward, man?
So this is a unified model that allows you to deploy and orchestrate very complex solutions in a very simple way, whether it be on-prem or in the cloud. And the beauty of this is that we've started off with a huge list of templates for you to get going. So you can learn from solutions either we've built or our partners have built to really get going very quickly and build whatever solution you may imagine.
That's great, man. Thanks for the overview.
You bet.
Now we're just about out of time. You can get started today with Quick Start Templates. Keep checking back to Microsoft Mechanics every Wednesday or as news breaks. Thanks a lot for watching.